This is a tutorial on profitability ratios. We are going to use this balance sheet and an income statement and calculate the profitability ratios which we discussed in the last video. Let's look at this income statement. The format should, as I said, you should be familiar with this format. You have sales given for the 2 years. The sales have been then categorized into cash sales and credit sales. You have cost of goods sold, you pay for employee welfare, depreciation, all the other expenses, and then you are left with earning before interest and tax. And again, I hope you are now familiar with this concept of EBIT. You pay interest out of the EBIT, then you are left with only EBT, earning before tax. Then you pay taxes and then you are left with net profit after taxes. So you can also call it NPAT or PAT, again a standard term. Out of the net profit, you pay preference dividend first as discussed earlier. And then you have the net income available to the equity shareholders. Out of that, you pay a dividend to the equity and then you have retained earning. Memorize this format. This is the sequence in which these calculations are done in the income statement. In the preparation of final accounts, we only discuss till the calculation of net profit. But now we have a new section here in which we are talking about distribution of dividend to the preference shareholders and to the equity shareholders, and finally retaining some amount of profit which goes into the balance sheet. And then you have some more information which is not necessarily part of the income statement. So you have number of shares which are given to you, and market value per share is also given to you. So this is the format in which the income statement is going to be shown to you. We have looked at the first section for the Reliance Industries Limited, but I've not shown you this second section about the dividends being declared and so on. I will do that as well shortly. So let's get started. We are going to begin with the gross profit ratio, which is equal to the gross profit divided by sales into 100. And let's go back here. Sales are 23,000. Gross profit has not been given. So when we prepared the account format of profit and loss statement, we worked out the amount of gross profit. However, in this statement, you do not see any amount of gross profit. There's only EBIT and then EBT and net profit after taxes. But not to worry, we know how to calculate the gross profit. The formula for gross profit is equal to sales minus cost of goods sold. Simple as that. And both these numbers have been given to us. So we are going to calculate gross profit for both the years 2020 and 2019. So sales is 23,000 and cost of goods sold are 15,000. On the other hand, sales are 20,000 and cost of goods is 12,000 for 2019. Now this gives you gross profit equal to 8,000, and in the other year you have the gross profit equal to 8,000 as well. There you go. Gross profit has been calculated. Now we have to divide this by sales. So 8,000, divided by the sales, which is 23,000, and you have 8,000 divided by 20,000. This is the gross profit ratio. Gross profit ratio in the 2 years. So all we have to do now is to calculate these numbers, and I'll just bring do the division. 23,000 comes out to be 34%. So 34%, you have to multiply this by 100 for both the sides. Then you have 8,000 divided by 20,000. This comes out to be 40%. So what we've learned here is that the gross profit in the previous year was 40% of the sales. However, In this year, it has dropped to 34%. The gross margin has dropped by 6 percentage points. So, you know, it's going down, cannot be a good position to be in. You need to go up, not go down. But, you know, we don't know the nitty-gritties of, you know, details of what business this is and what were the reasons. The purpose of this exercise is to only, you know, manually calculate the things to get a feel of how these indicators are going to be calculated. Then we will get into more, you know, in-depth discussions as well later on. So gross profit ratio has been calculated. Let's move on to calculate the operating ratio. The operating ratio, as we know, is equal to operating cost. So operating cost divided by sales into 100. Now we have to figure out the amount of operating cost for the 2 years. Operating cost for 2020 and 2019. So how do we get to operating cost? Let's look at the income statement here. Operating cost will include COGS for sure, employee welfare expenses, depreciation is also the operating expense, plus you have other expenses, and it says 80% of other expenses are operating expenses. So meaning you have to just get rid of 20% of this 400 and 400 and you have your operating costs. So the cost of goods sold is equal to cost of goods sold plus the employee welfare expenses plus depreciation and plus other operating expenses. All right, for 2020 we have 15,000 plus these 600 plus 120 plus 80% of this is going to be 320. So 320 and 420, 440, 1040. So 16,040 is the 16,040 is the operating cost for the year 2020. Likewise, we are going to calculate the operating cost for the year 2019. So I have again 80% of this will be taken, which is 320. And I'm going to add 1, 2, 3, and 4 items again. So this comes out to be 580. So 12,580 is the number. 12,580. Oh, I made some mistake here. Let me just go back. So this amount should come out to be 320 as well. So this should be 720 and this should be 1040. So 16,040 is what I should have written. So 16,040. All right, so you have the operating cost for both the years. All you have to do is to divide this by the sales. So operating ratio is equal to 16,040 divided by the sales, which was 23,000. I remember it from the previous calculation, and 20,000 in this case. All right, all we have to do is to now calculate. So 16,040 divided by 23,000 comes out to be 69%, 69.7%, and 12,580 divided by 20,000 comes out to be 62.9%. So the operating ratio actually improves. From 2019 to 2020, we have increased the operating cost ratio. So actually, this is not operating profit, this is operating cost. You have improved it, means that the expenses have gone up actually. So operating cost has increased. This is not a good situation to be in. You want to reduce your cost. In the previous ratio, gross profit is going down. In this case, the operating cost is going up. So certainly, there are, you know, some things happening in this business which is leading to increase in the cost, reduction in the gross margin. All right, let's go to operating profit ratio. The operating profit ratio is equal to operating profit, of course, divided by the sales into 100. The easiest thing to do is to just, you know, 100 minus 69, 100 minus 62, and you have the operating profit ratio. But just to make sure that if you don't have those numbers, how do you calculate operating profit? We have to figure out operating profit, and operating profit is going to be equal to sales minus the cost of goods sold minus all the rest of operating expenses. Operating expenses. Luckily for us, we have already done these calculations. This is the operating cost, total operating cost. We have already done this. And we know for 2020 and 2019, sales figures are 20,000, 23,000 and 20,000. And we need to take out the amount of operating cost. So operating cost can be taken from here. Operating cost is this number, 16,040 and 12,580. And there you go, you have the operating profit. So operating profit ratio is going to be equal to this divided by 23,000 here, the sales, and 20,000, the sales here. And when you do the calculations, the numbers you are going to arrive at are going to be 100 minus this, of course. So this comes out to be 30.3%. And in case of 2019, this comes out to be 37.1. So this is 38, 40, and 50. Yeah, that's right. 37.1%. So that's how you calculate an operating profit ratio for a company. So here operating profit is going down, not a good situation to be in. We've seen that gross profit is going down, operating cost is going up, and operating profit of course has to go down. Let's now look at net profit ratio for this business. Net profit ratio is equal to net profit after the taxes, and divide this by sales, multiply by 100, and you have the net profit ratio. For 2020 and 2019, we have to figure out the net profit ratio. Let's go to the income statement. Sorry, here. So net profit is 4038 and 4230. 4038 and 4230. This is the net profit. Divide this by sales. Sales, now we know the sales by heart, 23,000. And 20,000, multiply this by 100 and 100, and you have your net profit ratio. The ratio comes out to be, let's use the calculator, 4038 divided by 20,000, 20.19%, and 4230 divided by 20,000, this comes out to be 21.15%. All right. So the net profit is going down, not significantly, by a small number. However, we do not know what are the units. If the units are in crores and the percentage is even 1% makes a difference of lakhs. So, you know, the crux is that the net profit is going down. To sum up, till now, we have gross profit ratio, which was going down, operating cost ratio going up, operating profit going down, but finally, the net profit ratio is not going down by as much as the other profits, the operating profit and the gross profit were going down by. So this is the let me stop here. These are the first four indicators, and we learned how to calculate these indicators. In the next video, I'm going to continue the discussion, go to the fifth indicator, and using the same income statement balance sheet, we will do the calculations. I'll see you in the next video.